professional athletes. And this bill undermines the integrity of that intent, not only by cricket, but I know by rugby and other codes in New Zealand. Kia ora.
I call Paul Foster Bell.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for the opportunity to make a brief contribution in this debate on Mr. Mitchell, Clayton Mitchell's Broadcasting Games of National Significance Amendment Bill. I'm not going to engage in quite the same level of invective that the ACT Party leader did, although I do concur with his basic supposition that this bill is communism. And I have to say that this is ironic, given earlier in the day Mr. Mitchell made allegations that our colleague Mr. Simpson's bill, Scott Simpson's bill on giving high earners some choice around the negotiations in their employment contracts and the ability to negotiate out a protection that may be provided in the case of personal grievance. Mr. Mitchell thought this was fascism. Now, I think we have to be very careful when we hurl these sorts of terms across the House, because when one accuses another member of fascism, these terms should be reserved for when things are actually fascistic. Otherwise, we run the risk of being the boy who cried wolf. But in this case, I do agree with the basic supposition of Mr. Seymour that this is a communistic measure and that it seeks to socialise, I think, what is entertainment. And since when did the ability to turn on the television and enjoy one's favourite form of entertainment become a human right? I quite enjoy The House of Cards, for instance, or that wonderful new TV series, The Crown, which shows our glorious monarch, Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, from her early years. The most expensive... Oh, Prince Philip, he was quite a good looker in his youth, wasn't he, Simon? But the monarch and her family... This is the most expensive TV series ever produced in history, over $100 million to produce it. And it wouldn't have been able to be produced in such glorious high definition splendour, with wonderful sets, amazing costuming, the best actors available. John Lithgow's portrayal, for instance, of Sir Winston Churchill is masterful, Mr. Speaker. This would not have been possible if it were not for Netflix subscribers contributing their $15 or so a month to enable them to access that subscription service. And in the same way, if we want to see high quality sports in this country, if we want to have a national rugby team which is able to continue to be the best in the world, if we want to have netball teams, if we want to have cricket teams that are performing at their absolute maximum capacity, they have to be appropriately funded. And like other members, I'm sure, I've received combined correspondence from the Rugby Football Union, but also from Cricket and Netball New Zealand, outlining the significant shortfalls in funding for those codes that would occur should this bill pass. And I have some grave concerns about that. So this bill does have, a good intention to promote the availability of live, free-to-air broadcasts. Now, increasingly, of course, people are accessing on demand because the live broadcast is at an inconvenient time. We've seen this with the Rugby World Cup. When it's been played in the United Kingdom, it's at a very inconvenient time, often in the very early hours of the morning that most of the games were played. And this House considered these issues at some length when we were looking at alcohol licensing and the very sensible measure to liberalise alcohol licensing, which in the end led to certainly no harm. There wasn't a great deal of drinking actually going on because many of the games were at 4, 5, 6 in the morning or at 7 in the morning, breakfast time. People were going into the pubs to watch the games over a latte and bacon and eggs rather than in the middle of the night and to watch them over a beer. But increasingly, in this world that we live in, people want to consume their media in a method and a style and in a mode of their choosing, but also at a time of their choosing. So I think the importance of the live match is something which is, Mr. Mitchell, unfortunately, slowly dying. Those who really want the excitement of the live game will go down and buy their ticket for the stadium. But those of us who prefer to keep a civil timetable and to go to bed at our usual time, we'll record the match and save it for later viewing, or we'll watch it on the delayed free-to-air coverage. And look, I happily concede, Mr. Speaker, I'm not as much of perhaps a follower of the rugby as Mr. Mallard or others, members on this side of the House who are noted for their rugby fandom, but I will watch those important games for New Zealand, but I'll do so on the delayed coverage. Right. Point of order, Mr. Speaker.
Point of order, Paul Foster-Bell.
I seek leave, Mr. Speaker, to table a letter from the New Zealand Rugby Football Union, Cricket New Zealand and Netball New Zealand outlining their concerns on this measure. A letter to me...
Is this in the public domain?
Has it been published? It was a letter sent to me.
I'm not accepting that. I'm calling Clayton Mitchell, 5 minutes unemployed.
Thank you, Mr.